Hey, all you crazy cats and kittens. It's time for another episode of Your Village People.
Sticks! Put them in my ass! Sticks! Put them in my ass!
My dick squeaks so slowly into butts of men who pee more than they shit. Then I deal a backhand to a bottom who has given me bad head. The penis stares you in the face and says, baby, it don't work.
You pop some blue and then you chew.
You pants yourself and jerk.
Dicks.
Sounding with the guys, I chase my anal dreams to put them in my ass.
I throw it fast, he stands aghast, then puts it in my ass. I throw it fast, he stands aghast, then puts it in my ass.
All the cum in the world can be gone. Need to drink on can't be gone. All the peppers are popping and my butt keeps saying, put it in my ass. In my ass.
Dicks! Put them in my ass! Dicks! Put them in my ass! Throw it fast, he stands aghast and puts it in my ass. I throw it fast, he stands aghast and puts it in my ass.
Dicks! Ooh, 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 dicks!
Put them in my ass!
Ooh, dicks! Ooh, 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 dicks!
Dicks!
Ooh, 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 dicks!
Put them in my ass!
Ooh, ooh, dicks! Ooh, 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 dicks!
Welcome to the Valuetainment Podcast. I'm your host, Patrick Buttpussy. Well, thank you for
joining. And I am your host,
Penis Butt Daisy.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us for
the name that you have given me.
You're welcome. I'm so proud to have given you my...
bestowed it upon me.
I bestowed my visage upon your nose.
Your what now?
My visage. I don't know what that word means.
It can mean whatever you want it to mean.
Welcome to another episode of the Villaggio Pipelio Pipelia Simianensi Pitcassio Ferroverite Cinemacoro Foraya Semenio.
Well, yes.
Yeah. How are you, sir?
I am good. How are you?
I'm good. I suppose we could talk about the movies we saw.
Yes, we can.
We saw a double feature yesterday. We saw Alex Garland's Civil War, which is not political at all. Do not let anyone fool you. It is just another Marvel movie. not a big crowd, but... a loud crowd.
Opinionated crowd.
Yeah, a very opinionated crowd. Almost like they were trying to be emblematic of the theme at hand. Couldn't make out the first comment that they yelled out, but it was something Democrats. So, you know, perfect right off the bat.
We can infer.
Mm-hmm. And then the second shout out we heard was just a boy, is she aged, in reference to Kirsten Dunst. And if you're wondering, it was a fucking senior citizen that said that. So, pretty ironic. Funny. and unself-aware.
Two geezers in the front row.
Dude, the second guy was literally, like, holding the back of his hip and walking as they left the theater.
Seriously? It took them about 20 minutes to exit the theater. Just the theater, not, like, the actual entire building. Mm-hmm. Just the theater itself.
And,
They got up at the beginning of the credits. Mm-hmm. We got up at the end of the credits, and they were just finishing walking out.
And then we saw Abigail. And I don't know if you noticed, but there was a common they had not a theme in common, but they had a scene with a theme in common. I don't know if you noticed, but both films had a scene where a girl had to climb out of a mass grave.
Yes, I was just thinking about that. I was like, wait, there was literally in the movie before some other bitch crawling around on dead bodies, just mm-hmm. grimy as fuck. And that's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's weird because the movie to me was it wasn't on the nose, but it wasn't like the subtlest thing I'd ever seen, but like people are talking about it as if it's like the most apolitical movie called Civil War ever. And I was expecting, I don't know, I was expecting a lot of that to be maybe because like there was no like Trump analog or you know, I was expecting a lot less action too, because just based on people's reactions and how people were complaining, I was assuming there was not going to be a lot of warfare, and there was. I mean, more than I expected. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, I remember there's a scene in the middle of the movie where they go to that town that is pretending like there's no war going on outside. And
that shit was crazy.
And then, you know, they're like, yeah, we just try and, you know, not to pay attention to what's going on in the news. And then they reveal that they've got gunmen on top of every roof. It reminded me of Gray's Lake during the BLM protests. I mean,
bye.
I just don't know how you can walk out of that movie and say it wasn't political. I think it made smart decisions, like not. Like, I think, you know, making the Western forces comprised of both Texas and California definitely blurs the lines. And I think that's purposeful because the movie isn't about like culture war or stuff like that, which I think people were more expecting because mm-hmm. the culture war is like more of what's driving us to civil war.
Yeah.
But. Yeah, I don't know. It was, I enjoyed it a lot.
It definitely surprised me. I enjoyed it more than I thought. And I think that's just also based on what we knew going into it as well. Like you had just said, and, you know, people were saying these one things, but, you know, really turned out to be the other. And yeah, I just end up enjoying it more than I thought I would.
Yeah, whatever that fucking synopsis that you guys read really pissed me off because...
Dude, literally, I had just Googled the movie and it was the first thing that came up. Like, I think it was the basic Wikipedia description.
It felt like it was written to sound like a completely different movie. I don't know.
Yeah, honestly, it's not what I thought.
Yeah. But, and I could have explained that, but... I don't know. Whatever.
But you know what? It worked out. I think, did you enjoy Abigail at all?
Oh my God, dude. I told you I didn't hate it.
Okay. I mean,
it's hard to have, Zach, it's hard to not.
The podcast doesn't know that you didn't hate it.
Right. Well, but you said, did you enjoy it at all? So, I mean, they don't know anything, but you started off with the impression that I hated it.
What? Sorry.
No, I mean, it was fine. It was fun. It's hard not to enjoy a movie when you're in a theater with people. But I mean, the fact that we almost didn't see Civil War because Sam suggested that and said it was a, you know, one of the best movies ever. that was definitely it was definitely a factor in my head. You know, I'm glad you paid for it, because I would feel awful.
You guys also bought the first.
I know. Anyways, what I'm saying is, it's a stupid fun horror movie.
Mm-hmm.
It was basic. I mean, it was almost a comedy. Yeah, it was fun. I had fun. I would probably never watch it again. If it was put on, I would watch it, I guess, but I wouldn't ever go out of my way.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely not a 4 out of 5 stars, as we were led to believe. It mostly did what I expected it to do, except I will say that there was definitely the business espionage elements I was not expecting, and also how fucking long the movie took to even reveal that the bitch was a vampire was insane.
Yeah, I think I knew going into it because of Sam, so I'm just like on the edge of my seat, like, when are we gonna find out
that I know because trailers. The trailers honestly made it look like the first 5 minutes is like them kidnapping her and then like basically immediate bloodshed once they got back to the house.
Mm-hmm.
I'm usually not one to complain when things are like slower, and it wasn't slow. It's just that I couldn't believe how big of a percentage of the movie wasn't a vampire movie. In general, it could have been shorter. It really could have. I know that's usually not something I say, but there was just like, you could have cut out a couple things, trimmed it down. I do appreciate getting to know the characters a lot before they start getting picked off, but I don't know. It could have been paced a little bit better. Just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I did think it was fun. They subverted our expectations. Whereas in horror movies, you're used to, the black person dying first, or the black guy mm-hmm. dying first. I think it's usually a guy, so it's not. I know I've seen ones where a black girl dies first, but it's typically a black guy.
And yeah.
They subverted your expectations because instead of killing the black guy first, they killed the white black guy first.
Shut the fuck up. And I whispered to Liz, like, oh, of course they kill him first. They kill the dead one first.
No. I mean, I knew he was going to die on, like, and that was going to be funny because he's dead. Yeah, rest in peace, Angus Cloud.
But also, he died, like, right when filming was wrapping up. So, like, he died in the movie before he, obviously, they knew.
Oh, I see what you're saying. I mean, yeah, of course. I didn't think that they killed off his character because the actor died.
I know, but I'm just like, say, that could happen.
I just
they
knew because of the nature of the movie.
Die later in the movie or survive. You never know. But then, you know, something happens in the middle of filming, so they gotta get creative with it.
Yeah. No, I mean, I definitely
decapitated. So definitely, it could. That is a great way to do that. Yeah. You don't need a head.
No, I mean, I knew he was gonna die, and that's what I thought was funny about him being in the movie.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I guess if the main characters were him and Sammy, the girl from Ant-Man and the Wasp Quantumania, or the girl from mm-hmm. Freaky? Is that what it is?
What?
Freaky? No, she's not the girl from Freaky. She's the girl from... No, yeah, she's the girl from Freaky. The one where it's like horror... It's like Freaky Friday, but a horror movie, and she switches places with Vince Vaughn.
Oh, I don't know if I've ever seen that.
Oh, okay.
But I haven't.
Anyways, a new twist on an old classic, but rest assured, they killed the black guy second. So all things are where they should be. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, the things that I would complain about aren't really worth complaining about because it's not a movie that's like trying to be all that good, you know? Like I could complain about like the forced, shallow, like I have a son backstory for the main character. But again, like that's not like the movie is not trying to be an inspirational story about a mother overcoming. So it doesn't need to work. Because it's just a stupid, funny slapstick. Not really slapstick, but yeah, it's the kind of movie you don't really see a lot anymore. And I think it's good that we can get that. But
I agree.
But you know, it's a streamer. Not something I would ever pay to see in the theaters if I had a choice.
We get it.
Yeah, so that was that. Uh-huh. Okay, so really quick, describe for the audience Sam's hair.
Okay, slit dye, black and blonde, and he has like
a juperm.
Yep. What?
A juperm.
I'm trying to think about the length. Is it down to his shoulders, almost to his shoulders?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. Shoulder length, curly
which
hair.
I'm personally, even though I've seen some photos since the last time I saw him in person, I'm not used to that length. I'm used to what his hair looks like.
Yeah, he has
like,
been
but
growing
not the
it
length.
Out.
Yes.
And he really just gets it trimmed when
it
he goes to his
It is key to the story. Because the last time I saw him in person, it was like mid face length, maybe?
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. So we got that other way. So,
and that was his first time meeting Liz.
It was. Oh my god. Yeah. I knew that yesterday, but yeah.
Yes.
I think it went well.
Yeah. He's beautiful Hispanic Jewish man.
Yes. We are all beautiful Hispanic Jewish men.
Of course.
Wait, what kind of Hispanic?
Mexican.
Okay. So anyways, so yesterday I was looking for the bathroom, and I believe I had gone to the upstairs bathroom, and this was my first time using the downstairs bathroom. And
yes.
It's weird because there's like it's set like when you go into the entrance, right? Like kind of like how recently Sara told a story not on the podcast about how when delivering a pizza in an apartment building, going through the hallway doors were the same door as the apartment doors, and she almost went into someone's apartment thinking it was a hallway door. Similarly, the entrance to the bathroom just says men, and then you enter the tunnel, and there's like a second tunnel that says women.
That's weird.
It is weird. So I knew I was going into the men's, right? Like, I had already looked at the signs and everything. I knew I was in the men's. I walk into the men's, and I saw Sam washing his hands.
Mm-hmm.
But I was like, I only saw shapes, you know? Like, because basically I walked in, saw Sam's hair, and it's like you said, it's curly. It's, like we said, it's much longer now. This was the blonde side. I don't know why it affects it, but it does. I thought I had actually walked into the women's restroom, and like there was like a middle-aged woman at the
Call him a faggot?
That's his fucking line. You're not allowed to steal that. No, I'm not. I'm calling him. I just called him a middle-aged Midwestern mom. But literally, like, I stepped back because I thought I had entered the women's restroom. And then, like, my brain received the information my eyes saw and was like, that's Sam. Or no, after my step back, he turned toward me and I saw that it was Sam. I was like, oh, Okay.
He told me about that. He did? I didn't know about your whole, like, encounter in your brain, but he was saying that he just saw you in the bathroom, and he saw you in the mirror, and he turned around and went, "Hi, Zach."
But he didn't catch my, like, indecisive, like, backstep?
No, he did not mention that.
Okay. He just saw that we met in the bath. He just told you that we met in the bathroom.
Yeah.
That we had an encounter in the bathroom.
Yes.
Yes.
A bathroom encounter.
Cruising at the Woodfield Theater.
Bye.
And then it was funny. If you could say that. We left the theater. And Sara was parked closer than my significant other partner. I stayed behind with Sara to take a dab because we had Sara had the long trip home, not us, but I was fiending. I took a dab and my girlfriend went to the car. And I'm on my way back to the car after taking the dab, you know, so I am under the influence. As I'm maybe like halfway to the car, I'm walking past the theater's dumpster, and Sara's friend Sam, who works at the theater, surprised me and said, "Hi, Zach," after we had just said goodbye. So it spooked me. And then immediately after I said hi back, I turned the corner around a car, and I was walking towards his car. The rear lights were on. It's like the same color as my girlfriend's car. And I'm getting in the car, and it's so funny because I have this thought as I'm opening the door, like, to make a joke to her. Like, oh, wouldn't it be funny if this was the wrong car? It was the wrong car. It was the wrong car. But I literally didn't notice until I, like, put my head, like, down below the door to peep in. And so when I do, and now we're like, I'm about to say words as, like, my head is going down. And then I see that it is a, not one, but two people sitting in the driver's seat of said car. And which, I mean, would have been really helpful if they were in their respective seats, because I would have realized, like, right away that it wasn't the car I'm supposed to get into. Instead, I like slowly peer down. I'm like, oh, this is not my car. And I was like, I'm so sorry. And the dude was like, that's okay. And I just was like, I like mouth vomit. I was like, what the fuck? And closed the door and just like sprinted away. Thankfully no one witnessed it. I really thought that Sara's friend might have seen it and made fun of me, but no one saw it. But now everyone knows. So yeah, that was that.
Amazing.
Truly, truly amazing. I gotta
pick again.
Little, I guess, addendum to last week's episode. I don't know why I do this, but, you know, I think of things after the show is over, and I feel like I just have to get it out. So we were talking last episode about bad baby names and celebrity bad baby names. Why? I mean, Bad Baby. Speaking of Bad Baby,
what you got against Bad Baby?
Nothing. I've got the appropriate amount of things against Bad Baby. But no, I just meant, like, you know, bad baby names. Well, her name's Bad Baby. It's just a stupid joke. And then also,
I think it was a really good joke, Zach.
Thank you. Thank you.
Of course.
And then also, I forgot to point out, like, the funniest part about the whole Cloud 9/11 thing. Is that the fucking Roman numeral 2s look like the Twin Towers. Like, there's an imagery aspect to this horrible, unfortunately named business.
It's beautiful.
I gotta pee. Alright, it's Sarah story time, guys.
Sarah and Beth is scared to death to hear what the doctor will say.
Alright, guys, we're gonna talk about sexism in the workplace. So as y'all know, Zack and I have been working at the Dom. And we have this one coworker. He's another delivery driver. And he's like pushing 50. He's one I have the biggest problem with because he will correct me on everything that I do. Yet, you know, the store does not believe in training. I was not trained on anything and I've been out of food service for a while. So like, yeah, I'm going to fuck up. I don't know all the fucking recipes and shit like that because, yet again, was not trained. He only corrects me, never any of the male drivers. He only corrects me and our store manager, who is, like, 2 years younger than me. The assistant manager he just flirts with, as well as both him and another insider will flirt with this co-worker of ours. I don't know how old she is, but she's friends with our 18-year-old manager. She is still in high school. And just the way that they talk to her is so cringy. And like, y'all need to be locked the fuck up for that. But that one said insider will also, his name is Zack, will just flirt with me a lot. And it pisses me off. Just the other day he told me like he loves hearing me talk and I just shut the fuck up. I just said okay and just like walked away because I'm good. I don't even know. I just like tune that shit out. I just get high and get left alone. Oh, another thing Alonzo does, he gets mad when I don't talk to him and, like, don't greet him every single time I walk in. Like, I'm not a talkative person in this work. I'm not talkative until I get to know my coworkers. But even then, like, this is not my industry. Like, this is not what I want to be doing. I just go in, I make money, and I leave. Most of my job entails driving anyways. So, like, why the fuck would I be shooting the shit with everybody all the time? But he doesn't like that. He doesn't like that I don't fucking converse with him. But I'm like, you don't converse with me. You don't fucking start conversations with me unless you're correcting me on something or just being fucking demeaning in some way. And I'm like, I'm over it. This is the slowest Zack has ever pissed, I feel like.
Really?
Oh my god, you're back.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's good timing.
It's been a while.
What are we talking about?
All of it.
Well, I'm cutting that part out where I instructed you, so what are we talking about?
Oh, sorry. We're talking about Alonzo and Zack. Alder Zack.
Great. I mean, I knew that.
Okay, sorry. I'm sorry. And about their sexism and their nastiness and their freak-ass behavior.
Are you done?
Yeah, I wrapped it up.
Oh,
I just okay. Like felt like I was going on for a while, and that's why I was like, "Damn, Zach's taking a while to pee."
That couldn't really have like been even 2 minutes.
Dragging the shit out.
That couldn't have even been 2 minutes.
Yeah, well, you're normally like 10 seconds.
Well, I mean, normally, I don't know. Anyways, Yeah, I don't know. Listen, guys, we got to put Jesus on the ballot. That's all I know. Come this November, we got to put Jesus on the ballot. None of this Trump or Biden. We got to put our Lord and Savior on the ballot so that they know we're serious.
Okay, well then I'm gonna put Abraham Lincoln on the ballot since we're just doing.
Sorry, I've been on Evangelist TikTok recently.
Sorry for you.
They are crazy. They are gonna put Jesus on the ballot. I don't know. But back to the movies really quick. I just want to say, you know, I don't want people to think I'm an elitist, which I am. But I just don't want people to think that. You know, it was Abigail was a fine, fun time. You know, I just am not as slutty with my stars as Sam is. You know, there's movies that are on my all-time favorites that have 2.5 stars on Letterboxd. You know, I don't get out of bed, or I don't give, you know, anything more than 3 stars. I don't give anything more than 3 stars if the movie doesn't inspire me or teach me something about myself or the world. So, you know. Yeah, now I definitely don't sound elitist.
Can you hear Mom?
What?
Can you hear Mom?
No, why?
Okay, because she's talking really loudly on the fucking phone, so no. I just want to make sure.
No, I can't hear her, thank you.
Of course.
Let's get that deleted.
Oh, I was going to get a dam, going to get a dam, going to get a dam,
going to get a dam, going to get a dam.
Ooh.
Oh yeah, the evangelists are—they're gonna call. Trump said this. Trump said that voting day this year is actually Christian Day of Visibility.
Oh. Yeah. Wow.
He probably said that on Trans Day of Visibility.
You know what? Mom showed me today.
What?
A TikTok where they said that.
Where they said that Michelle Obama is going to be president.
No, that was last week, Zach. Come on.
Oh, sorry.
No, it said that someone tried to shot Trump.
Someone tried to shot him?
Yep.
Oh my god.
The word for word.
They took the shoot. Oh, that's what she said?
Reading it. They said that someone tried to shot Trump today or something like that. I'm like, girl, why don't you just correct it? Like, why do you have to say
oh my god.
And then she's just like reading all the comments to me, and they're like Republicans saying like, oh, praying he pulls through, or some shit, not pulls through, but like, you know, praying he, I don't even fucking know, just, I was tuning it the fuck out, because I'm like, why are you reading
praying
these
he
comments?
Pulls through, like, as if he got shot.
Like, I just think TikTok should not be allowed in our mother's hands.
You remember last time we were watching?
I support the TikTok ban because of my mom.
You said what?
I said I support the TikTok ban because of my mom.
Yeah, it's scrambling our parents' brains.
It's like Gen Z is not the problem.
It's boomers.
We're altering the minds of the boomers.
Yeah. We're forever altering their brain chemistry. TikTok is actually worsening their lead poisoning somehow. It's mimicking the effects and doubling it.
Oh my god.
Okay, like speaking of things at work though, remember when our good friend Keith thought that Steve Irwin was Charles Darwin?
No, that was our boss.
What?
That was our boss.
I thought it was Keith that said that.
No.
She guessed Steve Irwin?
No, he corrected her and said she's thinking of Steve Irwin.
Wait, so she thought that the guy that came up with the theory of evolution was killed by a stingray, and then he corrected her by saying,
no,
that's Steve Irwin?
His name was Charles.
Oh.
And then we're like, who the fuck, where did you get Steve from?
Oh,
and then
she was saying Steve Darwin.
And then
he
remembered his last name, and then he figured it out.
Jesus Christ. He cracked the code.
Yep.
Remember when we were watching Invincible last? And Mark and Omni-Man got fucked up in that fight with the Viltrumites? And you said that Mark got his guts rearranged and Omni-Man got his back blown out?
Yes, I did say that.
It was funny when you said that.
Yes, it was, because it was true.
It was true.
And it was
they
factual.
They got their guts rearranged and their backs blown out.
We live in a country of truth. And so it's important that we deny trans people healthcare. Bless you.
Thank you.
Bless you.
That them dabs hit me.
Oof. Did you mention the part of how these nearly 50-year-old men bat their eyelash?
I only mentioned Alonzo being nearly 50 because I don't know Zach's age.
Did you mention how I think Zach is pushing 40 and Alonzo is pushing 50?
Okay.
Did you mention how these middle-aged men be batting their eyelashes and cooing at a, I don't know, 15-year-old zygote?
Yes, I just also don't know her age, so I just said a girl in high school, our coworker that's in high school, mm-hmm. who's like only friend, well, not only friend, but like
who's
closest
only
friend at work is the 18-year-old manager that is still in high school.
Yeah.
Like Which, the like, young, other youngest person there.
I think about that, the fact that their friend's like, okay, well, he's 18, maybe she's 18, but like either way, it's like.
But like, yeah, she's, dude, she looks like a child. If she's 18, she looks very young for 18.
Yeah, oh my God, yes. I mean, she looks like she could be a middle school dog.
Dude, seriously.
And it's like, okay, dude, okay, yeah, maybe she is 18.
I do have to say, though, her makeup, it slays. But you know what? I can say that because I'm not a fucking creep-ass man.
Yeah. I mean, I just noticed, like, one day she started wearing makeup, so.
Yeah. She doesn't do it every day, but yeah, it's like once. I've seen it twice, but like once a week.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Stella.
And she's very quiet and like not very talkative besides with, you know, her friend and also the other manager that I mentioned that Alonzo hits on and doesn't criticize because he has a big fat crush on her. Like, she's not a very talkative person, so like I feel like
That's
she's not the type
her.
Of person to like speak up and be, you know, say if she's uncomfortable or something.
Yeah, I mean, this could be her first job.
Exactly.
Like,
yeah. I mean, hey, my first job was a pizza place too.
But yeah. Okay, we need to get that to stop. Well, and then there was that other, there was a, like maybe a couple weeks ago we were dabbing in the car at work and there was a fucking dude who like ran past our car to go into Domino's and like as soon as he got to the door, he was like a video game character who as soon as he like got to the door, like an animation kicked in and like he skipped a few frames and like he was like still like walking in place until he like grabbed the door. It was so fucking weird. It's like an N64 character.
What the fuck?
You don't remember that?
No, I do not.
Oh man, it was right in front
I
of
you
our
were
faces.
About to tell the story about the guy who saw you dabbing and asked what the device was.
Oh yeah, that was fun.
Arcane, haven't we told that story?
No.
Do you want to tell that one?
You tell it because I think you remember better.
Okay. Well, I actually wasn't in the car with him. Mm-hmm. I was inside, but some guy had passed Zach in our car dabbing, and we have our little Puffco device, and it looks very beautiful and futuristic because it's an E-ring. And I think Zach had the window open or something, and the guy was like, you know, is that a vape? What is that? Like, that's sick. And Zach's like, nah, bro, it's for wax. And the guy was like, oh, I can't do wax. It's too harsh for me. You know, I just stick to coke.
That was so funny, dude. And he said that, like, he was pulling away. Like, we were having a conversation, like, between cars. And as he's backing out, he's like, nah, yeah, I can't do that shit too harsh. I just stick to coke. Have a good one, bro. It was just like, dude, like, why did you bury the lead like that?
Like, how you can't just leave me on that note, bro. It's too much. And then there's also another store that is owned by the same person who owns our store. Their group chat is a picture of the owner, but like as a cat boy with like cat ears and like with a choker on and stuff. Femboy Robbie.
Of course.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy.
It's so crazy.
Crazy.
It is just so crazy, you know? We are living in modern times, and it's just so crazy, you know?
Are you picking up on this?
Timmy? Yeah.
Great.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Okay, well, he stopped, thankfully.
Did you hear about the Cybertruck owner who got their like accelerator pedal stuck?
No.
So apparently, like on the floor of the Cybertrucks, they're like the little alcove, I guess, where the gas and brake pedals like depress into. The dimensions are fucked.
Oh my god.
And if you push the gas pedal all the way down into the floor, it gets stuck.
Wow.
Yeah. So someone like, I don't know, drove through their own house or something because of that.
Jesus Christ.
So Elon is just having a wonderful time.
Yeah.
Did you see that fucking that video of him on like some red carpet just doing like 1,000 different poses?
Yes.
And then someone animated in a Fortnite emote wheel.
Yes, I have seen that. And there's also a version where someone does traits from The Sims, because like when you pick a trait in The Sim, it has this little animation for it.
Yeah.
So I think it was evil, goofball, and snob. And it was perfect.
I know. Oh my god, I can picture it.
I sent that one to you, I think.
And then I don't know if you are familiar, but he's got like a breeder kink. Elon?
I didn't know that. No, I didn't.
Yeah, he's got a breeder kink slash, it's like kink slash like maniacal plot to take over the universe.
Oh, well, of course.
So he's got like 10 children across like,
oh, I didn't know about this. Yeah.
Across like 6 baby mamas.
Yeah.
Like one of them was like a girl that he worked for and like just like, I think like paid her or gave her something to have his kid. Obviously there's like that massage therapist that he like offered a pony to in exchange for a happy ending, sort of unrelated, but I'm sure if she had been amenable to that, he would have eventually been like, you know, why don't you have a baby of mine? But yeah, so, you know, he's trying to be, you know, Vince Vaughn, the delivery man. He's trying to spread his seed across the globe. Basically he thinks, you know, his genetics are superior, and if there was more of him in the world would be better. If there was multiple Elon Musks, you know, we could go to Mars 16 times. So I'm thinking of writing a movie, a sequel to John Tucker Must Die, and I'm calling it Elon Must Bust.
Elon Must Bust.
So looking for investors. And I'm also looking for my star. So send in your Elon impressions.
You know who would make a good Elon?
Tell me.
I don't know his name, the actor's name.
Mm-hmm.
But the guy who played the dumb muscle in Abigail.
Dude, that's the fucking guy that I was trying when I was showing you like the image from the trailer for Abigail, and I was like, oh look, it's that guy who shows up and everything. That's that guy.
Oh, okay.
That's the guy who was like a henchman in Lost.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, dude, he used to be in Elon.
No, you're actually completely right. If he could just like do the reverse break your leg surgery where you get taller and got shorter. Mm-hmm. Oh my god. And just, you know, lost all the muscle, it'd be fucking perfect.
They could make him short.
Yeah. Again, just like the reverse, whatever they do for Tom Cruise. Or they can make everyone else taller in the movie.
That is also an option.
That is actually perfect. Dude, the accent he was doing in that movie was insane. That was so
he was
goofy.
Supposed to be Canadian. Well, but like,
yeah, and it did not come off stupid. As Canadian. It came off as Slavic as fuck.
It really did.
And this one, you know, I was talking about, you know, like, you know, to give a movie anything over a 3, I need to learn something new, or like, you know, whatever. And what did I learn from that movie? That we can't trust guys from Queens? I already know that. Like, yeah, you can't trust a fucking greasy Italian. Everyone knows that.
Get with the program.
But yeah, so we're casting for the movie. Obviously, you know, you're expected to gain weight or lose weight, depending. You know, but we need everything in the right place. And also, you know, pigment is a big thing. So, I mean, I guess it'd be kind of funny to race swap Elon. That would piss a lot of people off. We can make him South African, but black.
Oh, my God. We can,
oh, my God. Trevor Noah is Elon Musk. Elon Musk bust 2026. Dude. Oh, my God. No. That is genius.
No.
No?
He would never.
I think he would. I mean, if he understands the project, you know, what we're going for, you know, satire, you know, some sort of like, you know, holding a mirror up to society, like, you know, we're all Elon, actually. I think he'd go for it. I think he would. And I mean, I don't think he's working right now, so he's open. He's available.
He's owning X.
I'm talking about Trevor Noah.
Oh, sorry.
But yeah, it is a full-time job syncing the world's biggest social media. Oh, it's not the world's biggest, but it is a full-time job syncing one of the most successful social media platforms of all time.
Seriously.
So let's not, you know, he's no slacker. I think that's also a nap. All right, I got to pee again, so.
Damn, diabetic. Sorry.
Sarah Story Hour. And you know what? I need to go to the doctor, so please don't scare me like that.
I know. I'm sorry. That's why I immediately said I'm sorry, okay? Because I know it's fucked up.
But I also hydrate a lot, so I'm actually not, like, that concerned.
Yeah. How are your ankles looking?
So, yeah, I think I should get more credit. You know, I just downed a whole venti iced Americana. And
Americano.
No, I'm Latina. It's Americana. It's girly.
Take back.
I'm halfway through a 40-ounce water. So, I think I've earned a couple squirts. Wouldn't you say?
You have earned a couple squirts.
Oh, okay. I think we're just kind of like getting off like random work stuff. They tell you about the time that Donovan, our manager,
one who's in high school and is friends with the other high schooler.
Yes.
For context and for to connect to other stories.
Okay. One time, he said he asked me if I wanted to prep, and I thought he was asking if I wanted some prep, and I said,
stop. And what did you say?
I said, that's okay, I'm straight.
Straight people should take prep as well.
Okay, that's okay, I'm in a committed relationship. That's okay. I practice safe sex against my will.
It's my will.
I have never in my life consented to a condom. I just want to put that out there.
All right, Zach.
What?
And get a vasectomy.
Dude, I fucking would.
You have
Yeah, I'm sorry. I have what? Not health insurance.
Why do you think I stopped myself?
I know. I'm just making comedy.
I'm sure there's a way you can get a vasectomy.
Yeah, I mean, the black market?
No! Like, I know.
Liz wants to go to Mexico and get a BBL. Maybe I'll get a fucking vasectomy while we're down there.
I'm sure there's clinics that will do it. Because sure
$3.99.
Don't want to. Like, there's low-income people who don't want to irresponsibly have children because they know that they can't afford it. But they want to fuck.
I mean, the thing is, though, because I've thought about this for many years. I think you know that. You also have to consider how much it costs to freeze your sperm.
Vasectomies are reversible.
Why are you sitting all the way over there? You're not going to ruin it. Why are you sitting so far away? You're fine.
Get Liz on mic.
I do have two. I could plug her in. But yeah, I mean, it's just, it's really costly to freeze your sperm. And it's like, you have to do it for an indefinite amount of time. You can't just let the payments lapse and then they let your cum spoil. You know?
Did they do that?
I don't know. I mean, you're paying for storage. If you're paying for a storage unit and you stop paying, they put your shit out front and people can pick through it. So maybe that's what they do with your cum. They just dump
free
the
sperm.
Cups on the sidewalk.
That's so nice.
Yeah.
Get it before it's gone. By gone, I mean bad. Gone bad.
Liquidation sale. Everything must go. Everything must bust.
Everything must bust.
Elon must bust. Coming to theaters
Elon
next summer.
Must bust. Elon must bust. Elon must bust. Sorry. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Those got quieter.
What?
From when we were testing at the beginning.
Oh, well, that's because I had to turn you down. So it had to go down too. But you're right, it is. It is not loud.
What's that?
Skibbity beep. Skibbity bop.
Skibbity bop and dreamer, yeah. What should I have for dinner?
I don't know, what are you thinking? Taco Bell, Chipotle?
Shut up. Because I had Chipotle last night, so literally my brain was like, should I eat Taco Bell tonight?
Jesus Christ.
Get out of my brain. I did not consent to you being in there.
Get out of my brain, you tumor. You know, I told Liz that her being here wouldn't ruin the podcast, but I'm totally going blank now.
You were just so mesmerized by her presence that you went mute.
I mean, I am going blank, but it's not because of you. It's a me problem. But I need to learn to do it with an audience. This is not going to help.
Was Liz not there the whole time?
Liz just passed me half a dab, so get ready for me to go nonverbal.
Skibbity bebop. All right, so you guys ready for Village People meet and greet? Y'all want that?
Well,
$100 a ticket.
If I can't podcast in front of my girlfriend, I think maybe we're a little ways away from doing a live show.
I didn't say live show. I just
just meet and greet. We're going on tour, Tana Mongu style.
We're going on tour, fucking Shoddy Bay style.
I mean, what? That fucking fans? We're doing a fuck-a-fan?
What?
How many episodes have you listened to?
At least three.
Well, I've got bigger fans than that. Sorry to tell you. My girlfriend raised her hands when I said we're doing a fuck-a-fan, but she is not in the raffle.
Oh, what?
Let me see how many episodes you have downloaded. Well, then you're not in the raffle. I need downloads.
How do you even do that, Zach?
It's next to the episode description. It's the little down arrow. You know? See? Oh, you fucker! You little lying whorelet! Where was that playlist? Pull that playlist back up. Look at all... Okay, look at all that downloaded music.
Oh, that's what that means?
Yeah.
Okay,
it saved your device.
Okay.
Caught. Exposed. Cancelled.
Chill the fuck out.
This is... I'm just doing the podcast, man. What did you say?
Doing me, guys.
You didn't even follow me?
Wow.
Download. Download.
Can you tell me how improved? Because last time it was only this one. Okay.
Hold on, let me go slow. No, that makes me happy.
So.
I mean, I told you, there's no. It's a lose-lose situation here. Either you actually have met the threshold, so.
Damn.
Look at that! Look at that! You're officially in the raffle. Every download is another entry. So,
and if you subscribe to the Patreon, that's 10 entries.
Oh yeah, if you subscribe to the Patreon, that's 10 entries.
What the fuck is, do I have to pay for that?
Yes.
Let me get a job.
Well, there is a free tier.
Let me get a job.
There is a free tier. There's a free tier. No, but I mean, I told her a couple weeks ago that it's a lose-lose situation. Either well, my girlfriend listens to the podcast. Or not even my girlfriend listens to the podcast. So but we are staunchly in the at least my girlfriend listens to the podcast column. A little bit of column A, a little bit of column B. Huh?
Wolfie said he's listened.
I know he's listened. But is he listening? Is he keeping up?
Trickle a little thing and see if
he
catches it.
Trickle a little thing?
Mm-hmm. Like, say something that only Wolfie would understand. And then see if he says it.
You mean only a listener would understand?
Sure.
Okay. Well, some... Yeah. Maybe.
Pop quiz.
Code. Some coded... A coded drop.
Okay, yeah. The Da Vinci code.
Mm-hmm.
The Village People Code.
Oh, episode title. Da Vinci Code. The Da Vinci Chode.
Da Vinci!
The Da Vinci Chode. No, this is fine.
Okay.
You're helping, baby.
Okay.
You broke my Da Vinci Chode.
Da Vinci?
Da Vinci? All right. Let's get serious.
All right,
let's get fucking serious, dude.
Let's get fucking serious about the Vinci Code.
Oh, here,
man.
Liz. You can be like Sarah. Just put it in.
Are they gonna hear me?
No.
Is she mic'd up, Shoddy?
Think I'm that tacked up? No, she's not mic'd up, Shoddy. I have another mic, but I don't think she's ready for that. Yeah.
Okay.
She's gonna be like my Nia, you know, on Bill Burr's podcast. She'll pop in. I'll yell at her, and she'll like say one thing, and then it'll grow from there, and then eventually one day she'll sit down. Yeah, I think we're good.
Okay.
Sarah, do your job.
All right, guys, you know what to do. Subscribe to the Patreon, patreon.com/TPPpod. Do it or die.
Do it or die. No, no extended episode this week on the Patreon because no one came last week. Just kidding. We just are not physically capable of it this week. Maybe next week. And also next week, the boy is coming home Leginaville will, the sequel to Leginaville will be next week. Legarius Jamal Johnson, the prodigal son, returns.
Oh my god.
One night only. So, it's gonna be great.
You should have him talk about his girlfriend.
Oh, believe me, we will. We'll talk about the snail trail.
Oh,
we'll
God.
We'll talk about the Midwest genes. We'll talk about her rosacea. Mm-hmm. We'll talk about it all. So.
Tune in on Leginaville Part 2.
Until then, we ball.
If I could stick my dick in your butt, spill nut all over your face, would it satisfy you? Would it slide inside you? Would you think this boy is gay? Ain't he gay? If I could stick you, if I could sting you with my dick so divine, would it be enough for your stinky butt? If I cream pied, if I pie, I said, I know it's only cock and balls, but I like it. I know it's only cock and balls, but I like it, yes I do, well I like it. Said, can't you see that this old queen has been a horny? If I could stick a dick in your butt and bust like it was a race, would it be enough for to engage bust? Would it help to give me brain? If I could dig down in your butt, penis would flood your tank. Would it satisfy? Would it slide inside? Would you think this boy is gay? He is gay. I said, I know it's only cock and balls, but I like it. I said, I know it's only cock and balls, but I like it, yes I do, well I like it, yeah I like it, ooh I like it. Can't you say that this old queen has been a horny?
Yeah, tune in next week for... Well, actually, I think it's technically it's his third appearance, actually. So, next week...
Part 3.
The sequel was Legina in Space. This will be...
The Return of Leginaville?
No, it's Return to Leginaville, actually.
Return to Leginaville, of course. Yes,
so next week will be... When return to Leginaville. And what a warm homecoming it will be. Yeah. Alrighty then. Sara?
Alright. It's been sexy.
Go fuck yourself.
Okay. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you, I'm hanging up. Bitch.
Fuck you, I'm hanging up too.
Fuck you.
No, fuck you. Oh, she hung up. It's rude.
I know. 97 W.
T.